Hello, I've been using SQL Server 2019 Linux version running on containers for one of my projects. Recently, I upgraded my machine from an old MacBook Pro 2017 model to the new Apple Silicon M2 version of the processor. I wanted to run this same SQL Server 2019 image on this latest hardware and see how does it perform. Let's see how we can get started and run SQL Server 2019 on M1 Mac or M2 Mac for that matter. Apple Silicon, basically, Apple Silicon based processor. If you want to run SQL Server in container, we can head over to the MS SQL Server official images on Docker Hub. And this page tells us how to get started with SQL Server. There are three different versions. One is the 2017 latest, there is 2019 latest, 2022 latest, and there is also a preview version of 2022 Ubuntu running on 22.04 Linux version. I would go with 2019, that is what I've been using in my project. How do we use this image? We can run this Docker run command and pass some environment flags to set the environment variables so that the image is initiated or the SQL Server is initiated with the right set of parameters. We can use things like accept EULA or end user license agreement and say yes, because we need to agree to the end user license agreement. We also have to provide a strong password for the system administrator or SA user, and we do the port mapping. Along with this, we can also specify what is the product ID. In case of SQL Server 2019 or 2017 or the SQL Server version of container image, it supports these five different versions or product IDs, product editions basically. Default is developer if we don't specify anything. Otherwise, we can use things like Express Edition, Standard, Enterprise or Enterprise Core. And for a developer scenario where I want to test these things, developer or Express Edition is more suitable. So I'm going to use the Express Edition in this case. I have the command ready, and let's run this on the terminal. We run the Docker run command and we pass these three flags, one which is the accept EULA. We say yes. I set the password as a strong password. The product ID is set as Express. I want to give the host name as well as SQL Server, and I do the port mapping for 1433 port to expose the port on my local machine with the same port which is exposed by the SQL Server container. And the image we use is SQL Server 2019 latest. Let's run this and see what happens. First thing we see is a warning here which says that the requested image platform, which is Linux or slash AMD64, does not match the detected host platform, which is ARM64. Because I am running the Apple Silicon, it's running on ARM64 or V8 version of the processor architecture, and there is no specific image provided by SQL Server which matches this platform. As a result of this, what happens is if I go and look in the containers section of Docker desktop, we see that the container has exited. It tried to start this SQL Server, but because of some error, because of that mismatch in the architecture of the processor, it's not able to start. And we see somewhere along the line this message or this error which says invalid mapping of address. And because of this, I cannot run a SQL Server container version in Docker desktop, which is running on Apple Silicon. Now, it's a shame that if we can't run SQL Server or a database on the most advanced processor which is available from Apple. There is a workaround. So what I will do is I will remove this particular failed image or exited image and use the workaround solution. The workaround is to use what is called as the Azure SQL Edge version. Azure SQL Edge has a SQL engine compatibility with SQL Server, and it is built for the edge deployment, where we want to deploy it in an environment like IoT sensor or at the edge devices where it wants to interact with the edge devices. So this particular page, I will put a link to that. It talks about what are the features of SQL Server Edge, and we can use this as a replacement instead of running SQL Server on Apple Silicon. So the official image is again provided by Microsoft for Azure SQL Edge. And if we look at the tags, there is only the latest tag available for SQL Server Edge. There is no distinction between 2017 version, 2019 or 2022. only one tag is available. The other parameters which are used, like the end user license agreement, the password, they remain the same. And in terms of the environment variable for the product ID, currently it supports only two product versions, the developer and premium. If we don't specify anything, default is the developer edition or developer version, and premium is used for deploying to the production environment. So I will go with the developer edition here, and I'm going to run a slightly different version of the command where we pass the same first three parameters. The host name I'm using here is SQL Edge, and the image that I'm going to use is Azure SQL Edge. So let's run this on the terminal and see what happens. So the container is started. We don't see that error like in case of a SQL server, which we saw earlier because of the difference in the platform. And if we go to the Docker desktop, we can see that it is running and looks like everything is running fine. Let's look into the logs of that particular container. And it does give quite amount of logs, which is the starting of the process and what goes on when the SQL Server Edge edition is started. So it looks like everything is fine. And it does say somewhere that it is running, starting the database master, and the server is ready for accepting the connection. So we can connect to this by using a client tool, and I'm going to use Azure Data Studio. In terms of the connectivity, I'm going to add this server and use the connection type as Microsoft SQL Server, use the input type as parameter, and provide these things like localhost as the name of the server. If I'm using some different port, then I will use comma the port number, but since we are using 1433, which is the default port, there is no need to provide the port. The type of authentication we are going to use is SQL Server login, and the login name or the username is SA here, and password is whatever is the password we specified at the time of spinning of that image. I will provide that same password and hit the connect button. It will ask us to enable the trust server certificate, which is okay. Looks like I entered the wrong password. Let me try to enter it again. And here we are connected to the SQL Server. Now we can run a new query, and let's go and use one of the existing query, which is like finding what is the name of the server. I want to run this particular query, select server name, or at the rate server name, and we see that the server name is SQL Edge, which is the same name that we specified for the host name when we created the instance or when we created a container from that Docker image. So that way we can now see that we are able to run a SQL Server Edge as an alternative on Apple Silicon based processor, which is M1 and M2. And you can override or you can overcome this limitation of running SQL Server. Hopefully you found this useful. You can use this for your development purpose and do your development with SQL Server 2019 or similar, because it has the engine compatibility with SQL Server. SQL Server Edge or SQL Edge Edition can be used as a developer environment for using local development testing. Hope you found this useful. Do let me know in the comments what else you would like to see in this channel. Please like and subscribe to my videos. Thanks for watching this. Until next time, code with passion and strive for excellence.